Hello everyone, this is Direwolf20, and welcome to episode 9 of Direwolf20's Let's Play series. I am grabbing the old handy ender. So last episode, I was playing with item conduits and had a really good time with them, as a matter of fact. You can see the nifty setup I did here if you weren't paying attention last time, and you will also note that this chest is now completely devoid of any ores or dusts, and it has all the metals sitting in there. So that's what we built last episode. We're going to be doing a little bit more working with the ender conduits here and getting them to behave a little bit. You can see I filled in all my little patterns here so that all the filters can work, and overall it's a perfect dust and ore processing system. However, I would like to do a little bit more sorting with Ender IO. Since, you know, I kind of started with it, I might as well continue along that path. Plus, I've never built a sorting system with Ender IO before, and it sounds like a really good time. So I'm going to give that a shot. What I would like to do, then, is start messing around a little bit. But in order to do that, I need to get more of these advanced item filters, which means more zombie controllers, which in the end means more zombie heads. I currently have one zombie head, and that's about 10 zombie heads too little. Now, the good news is that the ender here increases skull and ender pearl drops. So, not much use killing spiders with it, but if I run around and kill zombies with it, I should wind up having, hopefully, a pretty decent amount of skulls by the end of the night here. I guess only time will tell. Let's start by taking out this guy. Nice. Gotta love getting ender pearls, because that's something I also was short on. What do we got over there? Zombie. We can definitely up... Whoa, that did a lot of damage. There's a lot of zombies here. I kind of feel like I want to run at this point. Sneaky zombies and their sneakiness. There we go. Any heads from that process? I don't think I lucked out at all. Curses. Alright, more zombie killing from me. So, I'm gonna spend the night here killing some zombies, running around, looking around, see what I can't find. Then I'm gonna come back, hopefully with a few zombie heads. If not, I guess we'll have to figure something else out to get more of them. And I didn't think he would die in one shot, but okay. Yeah, if I don't get any zombie heads or anything, I'll, you know, come up with something here. All right, guys, back in a few minutes once I've done what I can to take out these zombies. All right, not a terribly bad night, but also not as good as I was hoping. I only got 2 zombie heads for a total of 3. So my slice and splicer is going to have a little bit of work, but not nearly as much as I'd hoped. That's all right. Well, it's actually gold, I think, that I need, right? So let's go with, like, 8 of these, because the zombie controller is going to require 2 solarium. So I'm going to need a handful of solarium anyway, so let's just get a decent amount of gold. And I'll also grab some soul sand, which we're going to need more of at some point. And we'll let the alloy furnace start cooking that up. I've been making myself a bit more bread here, so let's switch this guy back to alloy mode, and you two can go together. Nice. The slice and splice is where we'll be doing all our work in a minute, but what I do want to focus on first is maybe running some of the conduits here, and we'll kind of take a look. I have an idea or two on how I want to do some advanced stuff with some of these Ender IO conduits. I did, thankfully, pick up a few more Ender Pearls, so I can also cook up another bit of item conduits, because I'll have some more pulsating iron nuggets, so that's cool. I'm just going to snag all the things I need. How about I get ready? We'll get all the ingredients I need for everything I want to make. I'm going to make a couple of the advanced item filters by way of this thing, and I'm also probably going to want to go get, while I'm at it, more sugarcane so that I can get more paper. So, yeah, lots of things to collect. Back in a minute once I've got it all. Okay, guys, we're back, and I'm making comparators. That's right, vanilla Minecraft item time. But not for anything other than a crafting recipe, which I'm about to make one more comparator, I think. There we go. Now, I can take the advanced item filter. There's actually several types of filters from Ender IO. There's four of them. There's the basic and the advanced, which we saw already. But if you want something even better, you can get the existing item filter. Check this guy out. It's just a combination of the advanced item filter, one of those comparators, and a bit of redstone. And the existing item filter is a really cool, nifty gadget. What we can do is, so for example, I've also, by the way, extended my chest room here a little bit and drilled a hole in this wall. I feel like this works a little bit better for my purposes. Long story short, I might have barrels over on this wall eventually, but for now it's basically just dirt and cobble, and maybe I'll even move this barrel over here just to demonstrate the fact that this might eventually become a wall of barrels for things that I have a lot of, like dirt, netherrack, gravel, sand, things that you're going to want tons of, right? Then over on this wall, it's going to mostly be miscellaneous things. I'm trying to make it functional so that when I come in here, I don't have to go all the way to this wall too often. So what you'll find here is anything that monsters drop, any miscellaneous junk, that's this chest here, and then finally, this is any items non-monsters drop, like chickens and wool and stuff, right? And then down this line we'll have a chest for anything wood related, so trees and wood, any flowers. I might have a separate Batania flower chest, but I'll probably have a couple different mod specific item chests at some point. And then finally metals, dusts, any right now generic mod items. And like I said, I might have different mod item chests, so I might have one for like magic mods and another chest for technical mods, we'll see. And then this chest here, I haven't filled anything in there yet, but eventually something will happen. So let me sleep through the night, because the main thing I want to avoid at this point, I got killed, by the way, several times trying to adventure outside. So if you notice my experience is significantly less than it was since I last recorded a segment, good on you for noticing. Yes, it was not a good time. But anyway, let's start sorting stuff. So the main thing I want to do is get downstairs here and get ready to start doing a little bit of sorting. Now, I only have, due to the fact that I only had three zombie heads, I can only do this for three chests at the moment. So we'll start with the three, and then we can expand it as more and more mobs show up. So let's go downstairs and see what we can do. So what I'm going to do is grab my Yetta wrench, shift left click. This is going to be an insert mode, okay? All of these are going to be in insert mode, and I'm going to stick with the green channel, but I'm going to talk to you guys about channels in just a little bit and how we're going to use them. But basically what I want to do is insert into here on the green channel. Yeah, that sounds good. Cool. Let's do this. I'm going to say, yeah, these guys should be pretty good. I might actually instead want to do, instead of, I didn't want to do that. Where'd my other wrench go? There we go. I'm going to go in this chest here that has the dusts and stuff. That's going to be more useful. So this will be in insert mode, channel green, channel green, channel green. Then all you have to do is throw your existing item filter right in there. And what you can do is you can take a snapshot of the current inventory. And then when you hit show, you can see everything that makes up that current inventory snapshot. Pretty cool, right? And you could, of course, clear it if you wanted to, or take a new snapshot. So anytime there's a new item that we want to go into this inventory, we just make sure it gets in there manually, come over, do a new snapshot, and then boom, it'll automatically route there. And the same options as before: match metadata, sticky mode, which we don't have to worry too much about right now. 9 times out of 10, you'll want sticky mode disabled. I'll tell you more about that at a future point when I find a good use for it. And then or dictionary and ignore NBT data. So if, for example, we had, I don't know if any of these guys use NBT data. These use metadata. You can see that there's a colon after the item ID. So raspberries are item ID 4171. Blueberry is the same item ID, but with a colon at the end. So if I wanted all of these berries to count, I could tell it to ignore metadata, right? If I want to ignore NBT data, I don't know if anything in here has NBT data on it. The flowers, no, they don't have NBT data either. That would typically be things like your enchanted books, basically anything that's like one item but can have a ton of different, changes to it. So we've got the basic setup there. Now what I want to do is have an input chest, which I think will be this one for now. So we're going to go into here, and a good trick for this when you're working on stuff is to find something that's small. I think actually Ender Minis are pretty small. Are they one block tall? We're going to find out, because if I can get... Yeah, they are. Look at that. Cool. Plus they have the cool Ender Mini particle effects, which, can't go wrong with. Let's see. I can probably go down a little bit deeper here if I need to. And I'm just gonna go straight through. Do I have a shovel on me? No, that's alright, I'm almost done. Cool. So we're going to, for now, run this thing like so. Cool. And then I can connect it into here. Because I haven't set up the filter on this yet, I'm going to tell this guy that he is disabled, which means he won't be able to connect into this. Once I get more zombie brains for more filters, then I can handle and do whatever I want. Oh, I love being able to be this small. That is so cool. Running along the edge of the pipe and a one block tall. Gotta love it. So this guy will be set to extract mode, always active without signal. There's only one other thing I want to do, and that is connect over to the chests over there. So let's see. I'm just going to run straight over to here. You can see I kind of prepared a little bit. This is going to be my last resort chest. This is going to be, if I don't know what to do with the item, send it over there. And the way we're going to make that work is similar to something we did last episode. We're going to come over here and specify that each of these inputs, actually, can I go negative? I can. Cool. We'll leave them at zero, so I don't have to change all of them, but I'll change this. We'll put him in insert mode. We'll make his priority negative one, which should mean that he's the last place anything's going to go. Cool. So let's configure the rest of this stuff. We're gonna go ahead and do this and snapshot it, and do this and snapshot it. Cool. Or dictionary, I could enable or dictionary, that's fine. Doesn't really hurt too much whether or not that's on. It'll just mean that if there were, you know, similar items, they'd land in there. If we run into an issue with that, we can always change it. Cool. So what we should wind up with now, keep an eye, the last item in here is the miniature red heart. If we were to, for example, want to figure out where redstone would go, here's a neat trick. Check this out. This should work if I do it right. If I just right-click on this guy or shift-right-click, or is it on this guy? There we go. Nice. Item conduit connection to the up. Iron item redstone will be inserted into iron block 1502, 63, 539, 537. Let's see, Z537, X1509. So it could be inserted here, but you'll see that, yeah, so that's exactly what I expected to see, right? The first inventory is the first priority that it's going to get inserted into. So this is the higher priority. So the one at X1502 is going to be this one. If this inventory is full for any reason, it will overflow into this chest because we didn't put any filter on this. We said any items allowed in here, but redstone's the first. So if we check, let's just check this out, and I'm going to switch back to Direwolf. By the way, left and right bracket here to choose your guy, and if you hit the tilde key, you can make a favorite, and then when you hold the tilde key, you can see your favorite is listed down there. Awesome. All right, so right now I've got 64 and 53. If I were to go throw this redstone in here, boom. It'll start filtering out, and it should start landing right there. Nice. Anything that it doesn't know what to do with, like paper, for example, it's not going to sure what to do with paper, so it should wind up down here. Beautiful. So just by playing with the priorities and by playing with filters, we can make sure that the redstone always goes in here unless this chest starts to fill up. Then it will start making its way over here. If this chest were to fill up, well, then we'd stop extracting from this inventory, right? So that's pretty cool. So if I throw nether quartz in there, for example, it should land in this chest. Beautiful. You can see some landed right there. And like I said, all you have to do is right-click on the pipe with the item that you want to figure out where it's going to go, and it'll tell you. Look at that. 1509 or 1502. Awesome. And we can probably do the same thing with some metals. So if we checked the metals, for example, aluminum ingot, and we hit this guy. There you go. Nice. It goes into the chest or into the iron chest at those other block coordinates. So what I should be able to do now is I know that this is going to go into miscellaneous junk, and that's fine. And so will this, and so will this, and so will that. And all these things should eventually get sorted down into the iron chest. Ta-da! Look at that. How cool. I like it. So I'll go ahead and sort this thing. And let's go downstairs. Ta-da! And I'm going to go get all my metals and make sure that they all sort properly. These guys should all sort into the correct inventory. I bet you there's one or two that won't. Specifically the shiny metal and the dark iron at the very least probably won't, because I don't think I had any in that inventory when I took the snapshot, but that's fine. If we come over here, we'll find out that, oh look, copper ore is not sorting either. All right, well we better fix that. Make sure there's copper and dark iron, and then we can snapshot again, and we'll see that now copper and dark iron are listed in there. Iron ingots too. Wow, I must have used up all my iron before I did that. So iron snapshot, that's better. Everything else behaving so far? So far. Cool. So gold should all land in there. That's pretty good. All right, nice. So that's a little bit of the auto-sorting system. The next thing I'm going to want to do is probably get those items that I want to smelt down into my auto-smelting area. So how am I for the end item conduits? Not too bad. What I want to do is maintain this guy as being the input or the buffer chest for anything that needs to be smelted. So I'm going to wind up actually snagging all this stuff, and we're going to bring this here. So now we're changing it up a little bit. What's actually going to happen is we're going to do this. I'm going to specify that this is again an in and out method. The insert, and this is going to be items that are allowed to land in here, we're going to need to probably duplicate the filter that's on this guy. So that's this advanced item filter. Cool. You know what? I don't need to duplicate it. Yes, that is correct. Okay, cool. All right, give me 1 minute, guys. I'm going to prep for this, and I'll be right back. All right, guys, I think I have a plan. So we're going to insert into this chest anything that matches the item filter here. So copper, lead, all my ores, right? Anything that needs to be processed by this machine or this machine is going to get inserted into this chest. Got it? Now, when we want to check out extract mode, it's going to work very much the same, except I'm not going to need a redstone signal, so we can active without signal that thing. Or I could set it to always active, either way. But what I'm going to do instead is I'm going to change the channel. What I'm going to do is I'm going to say instead of using the green channel, I'm going to use the brown channel. That sounds good. So the channels are kind of like the redstone channels in multiple bundled red wire stuff. Basically, two machines on the same channel can communicate with each other. So now when I extract this thing to the brown channel, it needs to find a place to go that's going to match the channel. So if I come over here, because this is on insert, we're going to make this match brown, okay? So the way this works is you'll see green goes in, brown comes out. Cool. And then brown goes in, green comes out. I'm actually going to change that and make that blue. Now you'll see that blue's coming out. And over here, I'm going to have blue insert. And again, it's going to match all these guys. I probably don't need this item filter anymore. If I just make it so that the only thing going into the blue is coming out of here. Cool. Now what this means is the only side effect of not having the filter is going to be the cobblestone. So any cobblestone that gets generated as a result of this thing, you know how sometimes you get cobblestone at a low chance, that'll get smelted into smooth stone. I'm not going to worry too much about that. Cool. So we'll see how this works out. But basically, these separate channels allow you to control exactly how your stuff gets sorted around. So basically, items are going to come in on the green channel because upstairs, everything is green, and I'm going to keep it that way. Okay, so if we, oh, spiders on the roof, I'll sleep in a minute. So everything is green upstairs on the green channel, right? So everything's going to get pulled out of this chest, and it's going to be sent to the other chests. And if it happens to be, for example, an ore that I want to cook on the green channel, when it's pulled out of there, it's going to land into the chest. But the chest is going to pull out on the brown channel and only be allowed to insert into any other machines that have the brown channel on insert mode, which for now is only this one. We might change that up in a bit. Maybe we can have another SAG mill and we can have another brown channel on that one. Okay. Then it's going to pull out on blue and insert into the only machines that can insert on blue, which is the furnace. So we'll take a look at this in a minute. What we're going to do is first run some item conduits down here from up there. What this will mean is that we only have to run one set of item conduits because we can filter everything and make sure that, you know, it doesn't really matter too much. I'll show you in a minute. Let me get these things run. Hopefully, I can run this without too much trouble. Be back in a minute. All right, guys, so what I'm doing is I'm running these item conduits straight down here, and I only have to run one set because there's only one set of conduits that's going to come down here. These things are pretty smart, remember. In fact, I shouldn't need that one there. I think I can connect it right up like this on a little bit of marble. A little excited about that. So I can run the item conduits like so. So you'll notice now that everything is connected in the system. The item conduits here should be happy to talk to the item conduits upstairs. And if we went and got some kind of ore, let me go find copper. That'll work. Demonstrate this. Let's see what happens. You ready? I'm going to actually set this guy because I want you to see it. Oh, darn it, I didn't want to do that. I always forget. It's shift left click. I'm so used to shift right clicking anything. So we're going to set it back to in and out mode. Insert is green on channel one or priority one. Yeah. I'm going to actually make this a higher priority than any other chest. But it's going to have the filter so that only items that are allowed are going to be in here. And then extract will be on channel brown. And yeah, that's cool. All right, I don't need that. Yeah, extract. It's actually going to be insert is the filter. Extract is anything that's in the chest. So we're only allowing these items to come in or extracting anything on channel brown, active with signal, and then I'll have a redstone lever here ready to go. So if we were to check with the copper ore that I just got, which is in my miner's backpack, and it should work with, well, aluminum ore I don't think it'll work, but copper will, so that'll work. So if we came down here and said, where are you going to wind up, copper ore, you'll see the first coordinate is going to be down at Y level 55. It's that chest down there. Now remember, this iron block is always going to accept any item if there's any backlog. So if that chest down there fills up, no problem. So let's take a look. If I throw the copper ore in there and then we go downstairs, it should be in the chest, ready to be extracted. Okay. If we flip the lever, what's going to happen is it's going to pull out on the brown channel and look for anything that can accept on the brown channel, which is only this guy. Then when he's done processing, he's going to extract on blue and look for anything that can accept the blue channel, which will be here. Then he'll extract on the green channel and we'll be done. So shift left click, I just want to make sure. We shouldn't need any more filters anywhere. All we have to do is flip the lever. Ta-da! It's processing copper ore. And then the copper dust should land in here. Nice. Look at that. Now the only downside will be that there will be a bit of a backstuffing issue in this thing. It won't extract until this is empty, okay? So you'll notice that it needed to finish processing whatever it was working on. That's not a problem for me. I don't mind. It'll just slow down the processing a little bit, and if it ever becomes too much of a problem, I can upgrade the capacitors in this thing, or I can have more of these machines. And again, you don't need to filter at the machine level. You only have to change the channel color. How cool is that? That is awesome. So last setting change here, we're going to set extract mode to always active. We're going to get rid of this thing. And now any ores that I get, except for tin, because I haven't gotten tin ore and put it to the filter yet, but I will eventually, any ores we get will go into the chest, which will then get sent into the sag mill, which will get sent to the alloy smeltery. And then the copper ore should have landed upstairs in the chest that accepts copper ore, which would be this guy. And if you go back and check on the video, there we go. Copper ore. Nice. If you go back a couple minutes and check on the video, you'll see that we had probably a little less than a stack, and now we have a little bit more than a stack. So the only other thing to note now is that I have an extra advanced item filter, which I don't need to use anymore. So I can place it in a crafting window. You'll notice if you hold shift here, it tells you it's already configured with items in it. But if you place it in a crafting grid, it will clear all stored filter settings, which is fine because I don't want any more stored filter settings. I want to upgrade this guy, grab some nether quartz perhaps. Three of them I think will do, and a redstone torch or three. And I can get my comparator, and oh, you know what, I think I need three more redstone. So you and you. And then we'll do comparator. Yes, good. And this, beautiful. And then I can come down here. I'm going to, sure, why not? We'll do the wood chest because it happens to be the one. Insert, item upgrade filter, snapshot, show. Cool. And this will stick at priority zero, right? So the highest priority chest, priority one, is down there, only accepting ores. Everything else will be a priority zero, accepting whatever their filters are. And then this guy is priority negative one, which will be accepting, you know, exactly what we want it to accept. There's only one downside. You ready for the downside to this whole crazy awesome system I have? You can kind of see holes in the floor a little bit. Yeah, it looks a little not so good, huh? Let's solve that. So if we were to grab some of these conduit binders that I have a bunch of, and just put them in a crafting table like so, we get conduit facades. Nice. Then we can throw them in the painting machine like so, and they'll start painting. And you know what? Just because I want to speed this up, I'm going to throw this thing in here. It should speed this process up. Oh, nice. Look at that. Painted with cobblestone. So you can see that not only does the conduit facade be awesome because it allows you to cover up cables, but it works with chisel, which is super ideal. That's, by the way, like a brand new addition to this mod. He very recently made it so that chisel blocks could be made into facades, which I'm super happy about because I'm using chisel this season. So how do we apply them? Real quick. Right click. Done. It's all there. You can see that it's pretty much resembling exactly how the actual block would look, but it's actually placed on the conduit. You do have to place it on the conduit, or you can place it, I guess, anywhere, really. But you can see there. There you go. Nice and fancy looking, right? I can put the conduit facade. Can I sneak it under there? Maybe not. There we go. And done. Nice. Real quick trick. If you're holding the Yetta wrench, all conduit facades are hidden. Nice. So you can see here all the conduit facades are hidden whenever you're holding the Yetta wrench. But when you're not, ta-da, you're good to go. I guess I should show you one other trick with the Yetta wrench, by the way, while I'm showing you neat tricks that you can do with hiding things. Notice how over here we have two conduit types going into these machines, both power and item conduits. Once you have a larger system, it might become more difficult to see. If you hold shift and do the mouse wheel, and there's a key binding for it too, I forget what it is, but you can actually scroll through the different conduit types. So you can see down the bottom left, it's showing just the chest icon, which means it's only showing you item conduits. Cool. If you scroll again, it's not showing you any, I think. If you scroll again, it's only showing you fluid conduits, which, let's see, this is fluid. This is redstone. Okay, so this one's fluid, this is redstone, and then the last one is this guy, which is the energy pipe. And then one more scroll to see everything again, so you can see your items. You can see only energy, you can see items, you can see only fluid. There's a redstone pipe too for advanced redstone stuff that we haven't gotten to, but hey guys, that is a pretty fancy sorting system courtesy of Ender.io. But you know what, there's another spot for a facade. Ta-da! Cool. All right, so I'm going to clean up the flooring, and I'm going to go, I guess, hunt some more zombie heads, because I need at least half a dozen more of them. Yeah. For these guys, for the barrels, I won't need filters for barrels, so that's good. You know what I'm going to do? I'm going to craft a couple more barrels. Let's do that. So let's snag our wood. I'm going to definitely need more wood for this barrel crafting process. I'm going to go cut down some trees, and I'll be back in just a minute. For the record, I'm sorting my wood. How cool is that? It auto-sorted correctly. Now let's take a look at making some more barrels. So I think four ought to do, maybe. We'll start with two, and then we'll go from there. So I think that'll work. Cool. Yeah, I guess one more wouldn't hurt. Let's do three. And go. And there's a bunch of cool upgrades we can apply to these barrels, by the way, and I'll definitely be getting into some more Java mechanics in a little bit. But let's see, I want you here. We'll do a 3x3 type structure, and I'm thinking dirt, gravel, and sand. That sound good? And I'll probably have a couple more types in a bit, but for now. So what I should be able to do is the following. Let's see. And I know I'm being terrible, but that's what I do when I don't have a shovel on me. So I should be able to just place these on these barrels like so. Oh, it's going to be nighttime. I should be careful. I don't want any sneaky creepers or anything showing up, because that would be terrible. All right, that looks good. Let's kind of cover that up. I can facade that for the most part in a little bit. I don't have enough facades right now, so I'll handle it later. Let's sleep through the night. And we will now test sorting into the barrels. So what they should do is, because those are priority zero, that's the first place any item's going to go, right? This is priority negative one, so items shouldn't go here unless the barrels are full. And these all have filters on them, so nothing should go in there. So I shouldn't need to filter these barrels, because the barrels are already acknowledging the fact that they can only accept certain items. So if I were to, for example, come over here and just snag a bunch of dirt and throw it into this chest, it should automatically start dumping into the Java barrel, I would think. Except it's not. Where'd it go? Are you going anywhere? Yes. Where are you going? Not into here, I hope. Oh, it is going into there. Why is that? All right, so I'm lying to you guys. Let me figure out... Oh, wait, I know. I forgot. By default, this is something that confuses me a lot, because most other pipes are the opposite. By default, you're in extract mode when you set these down. So don't forget to change them to insert mode. And color's green, channel zero. Let's try that again. My bad. Creeper. Don't blow up my house. Nice. That was close. All right. Trying once more. So that's what would happen if you configured the system wrong. Let's pretend I did that on purpose as a demonstration to you guys. We configure it correctly. Ta-da! Dirt. Nice. All right. Cleaning up inventory. Back in a few. So the only other thing to note is that there is an item upgrade for increasing the speed at which this can pull items out of chests. It's right here. It's not too hard to make. It does require some iron and some electrical steel, however. So at some point, I will probably care more about how fast this can pull from the chest. But at this point, I really don't. It's not that big a deal to me. So I'll leave it as is. So we'll stick with this stuff for now. This can all go in here. And yeah, that looks pretty good. I'll put the wood in. Nice. So everything should be working correctly. I'm going to go ahead and move this back to right here. This is going to be kind of a catch-all for any blocks or anything like that that don't fit into the barrels, at least for now. I thought I had a little bit more clay than that, so it makes me wonder if it's in a different inventory somewhere. I don't know. We'll figure it out. But for now, I think we've got a pretty half-decent sorting system. Like I said, I need to get more zombie heads before I can do anything more with sorting systems and such. But at least for now, you should know where to go, both of you. Cool. Halfway there. Definitely halfway there. All right, guys. I will be back in a minute. Alright guys, so we've got a basic sorting system in place. I've got, like I said, a little bit more work, but I think the base is shaping up nicely. Once I get a little bit more of those zombie heads, which I'm going to make sure to carry around this awesome sword with me so that anytime I do encounter zombies, they die with the beheading. I might even get an upgrade on my sword, or maybe make a new sword, specifically purposed for beheading. There are ways to do that with Tinker's Construct. I might look at that a little bit. I'm going to want one anyway, because I'm going to eventually want Wither Skeleton Skulls, so we'll see. But for now, I think we've got an awesome sorting system. I'll clean up the basement at some point, as I've promised in the past several times and usually fail to deliver on, but I'll try. I'll definitely, you know, get around to doing something with this place. But for now, I think it's unfortunately a pretty good wrapping up point for the episode. We did a lot of work today. Cleaned up our base, reorganized some things. I definitely have more room for more chests if needed, and we have a fully, mostly automated sorting system. Like I said, a few more zombie heads and I'll be able to fully automate it, but the concept is there. All I really need is a few more resources and I can fully flesh it out. Like, I think 5 more zombie heads, and then everything's going to be fully automated. Maybe 6? Yeah. Can't wait. So I'll work on that between this episode and next, and then when we come back next episode, I will be ready to finish up my sorting system, at least for the time being, and do a little bit more aggressive testing with it. Just try throwing a bunch of items in the sorting chest and see what happens. For now, Direwolf20 signing off. Hope you guys enjoyed the episode. We will be back next time, and we'll have a lot of fun building crazy contraptions as usual. All right, guys, take it easy.